Hello, welcome. Happy International Women's Day. This is Katie, and we're going to be doing a workout with resistance and loop band. So you're going to need a chair, and we will also be doing some mat work at the end of the program where you can lie down on the yoga mat. So let's come to a comfortable seated position, sitting up nice and tall. Close your eyes for a moment. Calming your mind. Shoulders on top of hips, knees on top of ankle, stomach and chest proud. Couple more breaths, and we're gonna slowly open up the eyes. Inhale your arms up above the head. Turn the palm out, exhale down. So deep, deep inhale through your nose, and deep, deep exhale through your nose. We never hold our breath. One more. Inhale, lengthening the spine. Exhale down. Hands on the thighs, sitting up nice and tall. Stretching out the neck, next, ear to shoulder, extending opposite arm up. Using the same hand to guide or support the head. Lengthening stretch. Relieve any tension that you may have. No need to rush. We're gonna stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly come back to center. And now when you go to the other side, ear to shoulder, extending opposite arm up. Using the same hand to guide or support the head, stretch. If there's any stiffness in your neck, just stay here for a little bit longer. Stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Hands on your thighs. Take an inhale first. Exhale, we're going to turn over the right shoulder. Only go to where you're comfortable. Inhale, center. Exhale to the other side. Slowly, slowly come back to center, chin up, head back. And then chin to chest. Slowly, slowly come back up. And we're gonna look at the right armpit. Slightly tuck the chin in, 45 degree angle, looking down. Slowly come back to center. And now we're gonna look at the other armpit. Slightly tuck the chin in. 45 degree angle, looking down. Slowly, slowly come back to center. Take a breath here. Shoulder stretch, right arm up and across. Pull back. Creating resistance. Chin is away from the body. Eyes looking forward. Slowly release. Same arm up. Lengthen first. Place the palm behind your back. Use the other hand to guide the elbow. Tricep stretch. Chin up. Looking forward. Those who can bind hands behind your back, go ahead, binding hands behind your back. Don't worry if you're not able to do this. And then we're gonna slowly, slowly release, shake it up the other side, arm up and across, pull back. Creating resistance, chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Pull back. Slowly release, same arm up, lengthen first. Place the palm behind your back. Use the other hand to guide the elbow, tricep stretch. If you can bind hands behind your back, go ahead, binding hands behind your back. Chin up, looking forward. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. Hands on the shoulders, elbows and elbows up. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Feel the pinch in your shoulder blades. Opening up lung, heart, chest. Improving your posture. Oiling the shoulder joint. When you're in the center position, we're gonna come into a full circle, try to bring the arms close together. Connecting your breath with your movement. And we're gonna go the other way, reverse. Slowly, slowly come back to center. We're gonna inhale the arms up, lengthening the spine. Exhale, we come to a side bend. Outside hand, grab a hold of the inside wrist. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking up. Inhale, center, tall and long. Exhale to the other side. Outside hand, grab a hold of the inside wrist. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking up. Inhale, center, one more set. Exhale to the right. Release the bottom arm, top arm is the crescent moon. Chin is away from the body, looking up, lengthening the side of the body. We slowly, slowly coming back up to lengthen. Exhale, bend. Release the bottom arm, top arm is the crescent moon. Chin is away from the body, thighs looking up. Slowly, slowly come back to center and we get ready for a twist. Opposite hand, opposite thigh. Wrap the back arm around the waist, keep turning. Overlooking your shoulder, looking at the back, turning the neck as far. We're gonna inhale to prepare, exhale to turn a little bit more. One more breath here, we're gonna slowly bring the body back to center. Don't let go of the front hand. Inhale the other arm up. Forming a crescent, looking up.
She just wants to be.
Slowly, slowly release the other side. Opposite hand, opposite thigh, the other arm up and over. Bring it directly behind your spine. Keep turning. Overlooking your shoulder, looking at the back. We're gonna inhale to prepare, exhale to turn a little bit more. Stretching our lower back muscles, massaging internal organs. And we're gonna stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly bring the body back to center. Don't let go of the front hand. Inhale the other arm up. Forming a crescent, looking up. Slowly, slowly release hands on your thighs, sitting up nice and tall. Coming into your torso turn, starting our small circle. Gradually do a deeper and deeper torso turn. Moving your shoulders as well, warming up the spine. Make sure you sit securely on your chair. When you're in the center position, we're gonna go the other way, reverse. Slowly, slowly come back to center. We're gonna come to a forward bend. Inhale your arms up. Lengthening the spine, turn the palm out, exhale, hinging from the hips, leading with the chest. We're gonna dangle here for a moment. Let your stomach rest on the thighs. Release the head down. Lengthening the spine, stretching our lower back muscles. Just be mindful that head is below heart. So if you don't feel good about this, you need to slowly come out of it. One more breath. And we're gonna get ready to come up. Hands on waist for support. Inhale, halfway up to a flat back. Exhale to slowly rise up to standing or seated rather. Let your blood pressure get used to this. After forward bend, we're gonna go back bend to counter. So we're gonna interlace the finger behind, knuckles down and away from you. Shine your chest up to the ceiling, lifting the chin up, head back. Feel the pinch your shoulder blade. Improving your posture, opening up lung capacity, stimulating thyroid gland, and lifting chin up and head back. And then we're gonna slowly, slowly come back to center. Shake it out, getting ready for our bend. So we'll have all your equipment ready. And we're gonna loop the band on our forearm. And when you're ready, you can go open shut. Now make sure you sit up nice and tall. Shoulders on top of hips, stomach, chest proud, knees on top of ankle, abs are firm, small little open shut. Feel the resistance. Let's do another 4, 3, 2, and 1. Arms up above the head. Once again, small little open shut. Shoulders are relaxed. Chin is away from the body. Eyes looking forward. Don't forget to breathe in and out through your nose. We're gonna do another 4, 3, 2, And one, slowly, slowly release, shake it out. We're gonna do a bit on one shoulder, doesn't matter which one, opposite hand. Grab a hold of it, stabilize it, the other hand. Loop the thumb through and we're gonna extend. So I'll give you a side view. You don't have to sit sideways. Extend. So you can continue to sit facing me. Feel the resistance. So as always, we listen to our body to avoid injuries. If there's anything, any pose that caused you a whole lot of pain and discomfort, you can slowly come out of it. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly release and switching sides. So opposite hand, stabilize the band, the other one with the thumb through. Pull back. Now you can only do a little bit, that's okay, as long as you feel the resistance. Otherwise, we will extend the arm back, tucking the elbows close to your body. Now check your equipment often, regularly. Make sure there's not any wear and tear because over time, the band may break. Just make sure that it doesn't snap into you. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good, release. Shoot the arrow, so once again, loop the thumb through. The other hand, shoulder height, not down here. Pull back, shoulder height. Now if you can only do a little bit, that's okay, as long as you can feel the resistance. Shoot the arrow. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Switching side, shoot the arrow, pull back and release, shoulder height. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. Bring it behind you. Wrapping one arm behind your back. We're going to extend. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Switching side, wrap one arm behind you. The other one, loop the thumb through, extend. Feel the resistance. Don't forget to breathe. in and out through your nose. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Bring it behind our head. And grab a hold at both ends. So because this is a shorter bend, we can only move the upper arm. Take your time. So we are stretching, strengthening, toning the muscles, maintaining muscle mass and bone density as we age. Try your best always. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly release, switch inside. Take your time to set up. Back arm behind you. Now we're gonna move the upper arm. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. Now we're gonna do some stretches in between, alternating shoulder roll. Go the other way, reverse. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out, interlace the finger, press down, metal, push it away, up, push the sky away. So we're doing breast exercise, forearm stretch, and working the shoulders as well. Go at your own breath and your own pace. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. We're going to do a few rounds of wrist rotation. Strengthening the wrist joint, increase flexibility, mobility. Go the other way. Forward, backwards, back and down. Change leg off, give it a very gentle shake. Shake, shake, shake. Slowly, slowly release. And we're gonna grab the bend, move it on your thighs. Adjust your posture, sitting up nice and tall. Palm facing up, tuck the elbow close to your body. And when you're ready, pull it up. Let's do another four. Three. Two. And one, slowly, slowly release, switching side. Loop it on your thigh, palm facing up, elbow close to your body. Pull it up. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly release. Place both feet into your mat. Sitting up nice and tall. Thigh, hands on the thighs are holding on to the chair for support. We're gonna open shut, toes are pronated out, in, toes are pronated in. Opening up the hip joint. Feel the stretch in your inner thighs. Strengthening the quadricep to support knee function. No muscle in the knees, only ligaments and tendons. Abs are firm, so we engage the core abdominal muscles. Squeeze the belly tight, but not to the point of cramping. Now if you like, you can add the arms as well. So we're gonna open, close. Open, close. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Move the band further down to your calf. Adjust your posture, sitting up nice and tall. You can either have hands on your thighs or moving on. So whatever you do, don't lean back. If you need back support, place a firm cushion or pillow behind your back for support. Now with an inhale to lift the leg up. Exhale down. Point your toes up to the ceiling. We're not kicking. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Walking the entire leg from the hip joint to your feet. Stretching our hamstrings, ankle joints. Control your movement always. No need to rush. One at a time. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Connecting your breath with your movement. Make sure you're breathing in and out through your nose. If you find that your heart rate is going up a little bit fast or too fast, can't breathe, hyperventilating, then you need to slow down. Now we're gonna stay up here, sitting up nice and tall, small little open shut. If you like, you can add the arms. We're gonna scissor the arms. So if you don't wanna do the arms, no problem. Strong arms, strong core. We'll continue to work the legs. A little bit of coordination here. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. Now we're gonna place one foot in your bands. Adjust your posture. We're gonna inhale up, point the toes up to the ceiling, exhale down. So nice and slow. Now, if you like, we can do arm swing on the other side. So once again, a little bit of coordination. Get the brain busy. So we were working both the arms and legs. Let's do another four, three, two, and one, stay here. Now we're gonna open, bring your arms back, lower down. So knee up, extend, open, close, down. Continue at your own breath and your own pace. Coordinating your movement with your breath. Now when we're in the wide leg, you don't have to go very wide. Opening up the hip joint, stretching the inner thighs, and the other side, the arms are moving as well. Working the shoulder joint. Engage your core abdominal muscles always. Let's do two more. And one last one. Very good, slowly, slowly release, switching side. Lift the knee up first. So we're gonna get this motion going. Walking the entire leg from the hip joint to your toes, strengthening the quadricep, stretching out the calf muscles, hamstring, working the ankle joint by pointing the toes up to the ceiling. So one at a time, you don't have to kick. We're not kicking, abs are firm. Breathing in and out through your nose. And when you're ready, we'll add the abs. So leg up, up, up. So on the other side, we're doing an arm swing, palm facing down. Let's do two more. Slowly release, taking a couple of calming breaths, and we're gonna get ready, knee up, stand, open, close. So get this motion going, knee up, extend, point the toes up to the ceiling, open, feel the stretch in your inner thighs. You don't have to open up very big, know your range of motion, especially those who have hip issues or any issues at all. Now we're gonna add the arms. So we're gonna go knee up, extend, open, close, down. Knee up, extend, open, close, down. Continue at your own breath and your own pace. No need to rush, not a competition, not a race. Let's do two more. And one last one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. And we're going to put the band aside. We're going to continue with upper body, we're gonna go into cat and cow. So we're gonna inhale to open up the body, shine the chest up and seat it, chin up high back, exhale to close, chin to chest. So we're gonna continue at your own breath and your own pace. Inhale one way, exhale the other. Feel your spine moving, creating spaces between vertebrae. So cat and cow will help you with the relieve back pain. We're also stimulating thyroid gland by doing chin up and half back. Let's do two more. And one last one. Slowly, slowly release. We're gonna get ready for another twist. So we're gonna cross one foot over. No space between the knees. Try your best. Opposite arm, opposite thigh. So we're not using same, so opposite. We're gonna inhale the arms up. And then we'll bring it to the opposite thigh. Bring your hands to the heart center. Prayer position. Turn and look at the top elbow. Stomach not resting on the thigh. Now begin to stay here. For the more advanced student, if you want to open up the arms for more resistance, go ahead. So on this side, I'm just going to stay in the prayer position. One more breath, and we'll slowly, slowly come back to center, switching side, cross your leg over. Make sure no space between the knee. I know some of you, you cannot sit like this, no problem. And we're gonna use opposite arm, opposite thigh. So we're gonna lengthen first, and then we're gonna place the elbow on the outside of the thigh. Hands in prayer, press the palm together. Turn and look at the top elbow, stomach not resting on the thigh. Now you can stay here. If you wanna open up the arms for more resistance, for the more advanced student, go ahead. Now opening up the arms is totally optional. We don't have to do this. You can continue to bring your hands to heart center. And slowly, slowly release. Shake it up. Now we're gonna grab the long resistance band. Fold it in half. Sitting up nice and tall, I'm gonna inhale arms up above the head. Exhale down. So continue with shoulder exercise, upper body workout. Now make sure there's no slack. We're not going like this, okay? No slack. Be mindful for those who have shoulder issues, shoulder injury, surgery, frozen shoulder. If you're not able to raise your arm all the way up, no problem. You can go halfway. Continue to breathe in and out through your nose. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Stay here. I'm gonna go side to side, coming into a side bend. Inhale, center, exhale, come to a side bend. Shoulders and hips are level. Make sure you sit securely on your chair that you're not gonna fall off. Slowly, slowly come back to center. And we're gonna go into a big figure eight, like a kayaking motion. the other way, go the other way. Slowly, slowly come back to center, shake it out. I'm gonna bring it behind our back. Go side to side. Know your range of motion. Let's do a couple more. Slowly, slowly release, shake it out. Now we're gonna get ready to stand up. So take your time to come to standing. Clear your space. Keep all your equipment with you. Now we're gonna do another version of cat and cow. So we're gonna do it on the chair. Spread all your fingers, align the wrist with the shoulder. Ankle and hips align, neutral spine. We're not sticking the butt out, only the spine moving. So we're gonna inhale, drop the belly, chin up, look up into a cow. Exhale, round your back as much as you can. Chin to chest, like an angry cat. So we're inhale one way, exhale the other. Connecting your breath with your movement. Creating spaces between vertebrae. So cat and cow also help people to relieve back pain. Let's do two more. And one last one. Slowly come back to center, sway side to side, release tension in your wrist. Take an inhale to center, exhale to overlook the right hip, squeeze the shoulder and hip together, let the hip drop. Inhale, center, exhale to the other side, forming a C shape in your spine. One more set. Inhale, center, exhale to the right. Inhale, center, exhale to the other side. Slowly come back to center, sway side to side. Release tension in your wrist. I'm gonna come to arm balance, right arm and left leg out. Right thumb to the sky, back toes down, core strong. Neck and spine in one straight line and try your best. We're gonna stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly release, sway side to side, release tension in your wrist. And we're gonna repeat on the other side, left arm and right leg out. Left thumb to the sky, back toes down, core strong. Neck and spine in one straight line, working the standing leg and ankle, staying here for 3, 2. One, slowly, slowly release. Take your time to rise up to standing. Roll the shoulder back, hamstring stretch. So for those who can place the foot on the chair, go ahead. So on this side, I do modification. Front leg straight, point the toes up to the ceiling, back leg bend, hand resting on the thigh. We do not put the entire body weight on this. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Not dropping the head around in the back. Stretching out the hamstring, and we're gonna stay here for 3, 2, 1. Slowly, slowly come up the other side. So those who wanna do it on the floor, go ahead, set yourself up. And on this side, I'm gonna place it on the chair. So if you find that this is too high for you, too much, repeat this on the floor. Point the toes up to the ceiling, square the hip to the front. We're gonna inhale the arms up to length. Exhale, we're gonna hinge, leaning with the chest, holding on to any part of the foot of the chair. Chin is away from the body, eyes looking forward. Neck is long, spine is straight, and we're gonna stay here. Now feel the stretch in the hamstring. Staying here for 3, 2, and 1. Slowly, slowly come up, release. Alternating, bending your knees. torches are stretched. Shift the weight to the standing leg. Holding on to the foot or the ankles. Don't open up the knees, knees together. Take the foot into your hand. Abs are firm. Continue to hold on to the chair for support. Advanced student, if you want to turn it into balancing, go ahead. Quadricep stretch. Looking at a point on the floor or at the horizon, something that doesn't move, that's your focal point. And we're gonna stay here. For four, three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. Alternating, bending your knees. Repeat on the other side. So we're gonna shift the weight to the standing leg, stay grounded. Grab hold the other ankles, knees together, take the foot into your hands, abs are firm, eyes looking at the floor or at the horizon, something that doesn't move, that's your focal point. So hold on to the chair for support. Those who wanna turn into balancing, go ahead. Strengthening the standing leg and ankle, strengthening the quadricep to support knee function. And we're gonna stay here for three, two, one, slowly, slowly release, alternating bending your knees. Now we're gonna work on our glutes. So holding onto the chair, square the hip to the front. We're gonna bring up one leg, small little kick. Squeeze your butt in tight. Walking the standing leg and ankle. So beginners, stay here, hold on to the chair for support. Advanced student, if you wanna challenge yourself, cross the elbow, so your choice. Don't forget to breathe. Locate your focal point, something that doesn't move. And let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release, alternating, bending your knees. And we're gonna shift the weight to the other leg. Bring up the other leg. Small little kick, squeeze your butt in tight. Feel your glutes firming up. So once again, you can hold on to the chair for support. Advanced student, feel free to cross your elbow. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly, slowly release. Alternating, bending your knees, mountain climbing. Release any tension that you may have, stretching out the toes as well. Holding onto your chair for support. So beginners, stay here. Advanced student, if you want to cross the elbow, go ahead. Your choice. Stretching out the toes. Walking the entire leg from the hip joint to your toes. Let's do another three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Very good. And we're done with the chair. Your long bend. So from here, we're going to do a few standing. Place your feet on the bend. Make sure it's equal length. We're going to go into the chair pose. I'll give you a side view. We're not sticking the butt out. We're not pushing the knee beyond our toes. And we're not squeezing the thigh together. So nice and even. So get this motion going. You ready? At the arms. Single, single. Strong arms, strong core. Continue to work the legs. You don't have to go very far down. Fast to height. Slightly tuck the tables in to protect your back. Don't push the knee beyond the toes. Let's try some doubles. If you prefer to do single, no problem. You can always adapt, adjust, modify to suit your needs, suit your body type, and your ability. You can also do this without equipment. I'm just gonna come to a chair pose. Try your best. Let's do another four. Three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release. One foot on your mat. This side shorter. Coming up to the shoulder height. Adjust the length of your mat to suit your height. Make sure when you're here, no slack. Shoulder height. If you can only do halfway, no problem. Soft knees, don't lock your knees. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Slowly, slowly release, switching side. Now when you're ready, pull it up, shoulder height. Now make sure there's no slack, okay? Continue to strengthen muscles. Do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Place both feet back on your bend, crisscross. Go one at a time first. Bring it up to the shoulder height. Once again, adjust the length to your knees. Make sure there's not a whole lot of slack in your bend. Soft knees, don't lock your knees. Let's try some doubles. Once again, legs are hip width, soft knees. You don't have to lock your knees. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Now we're gonna make one side longer, the other side shorter, and we're gonna pull it all the way up. So adjust the length of the band to suit your height. Let's do a couple more. And one last one. Very good. Switching side. So one side shorter, the other side is much longer because you want to be able to pull it all the way up. Soft knees, don't lock your knees. Let's do another four. Three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Shake it out. Rear side view. Front knee's 90 degree on top angle. So we're gonna come back to a warrior stand. We're gonna pull it up and extend. Once again, adjust the length of your band to suit your height. Let's do another four, three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly release, switching side. Coming to a warrior stand. We're going to pull it up and extend. Strong arms, strong legs. Engage your core abdominal muscles. Let's do another four. Straight. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Stepping the back leg to join the front leg. And we're gonna slowly release and take your time to come lie down. So for those who don't want to lie down, you can observe. So I'm gonna have a sip of water first. Come back to the loop band, place it on your thighs, and we're going to slowly transition to come lie down on the mat. You're going to go into a bridge pose, bend both knees, palm facing down. When you're ready, we're going to lift the hip high up, forming a bridge. Exhale to lower down, one water breath at a time. So we're going to inhale up, exhale down. Engage your core abdominal muscles, your quadricep and your glutes are firm. So in other words, squeeze your stomach in tight, your thighs and your butts are firm, but not to the point of cramping. So for those who cannot lie down on the yoga mat, feel free to do this on your bed. Strengthening the front abdominal muscles and the lower back muscles to support your spine. Especially if you have back pain. Let's do another four. Three. Two. And one. Slowly, slowly release. Move the band to your calf. Straighten out the legs, point your toes up to the ceiling. Press firmly on the mat. We're gonna do some leg lift. When you're ready, slowly lift the leg up to the sky. And when you come down, slowly release. I'm gonna count down. Lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two. When your legs are 1 foot off the ground, bend both knees. Lifting the legs back up to the sky. Second round, lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two, don't drop it, bend both knees, lifting the legs back up to the sky, take a breath here, last round, lower down for seven, six, five, four, three, two, don't drop it, we're gonna pulse it up and down here, abs are firm, try your best,
Let's do another four. Three, two, and one. Very good. Slowly release. I'm going to come out of this. And we're going to go into a cool down. So we're going to raise your wiper, dropping the knees from one side to the other side. Let it fall wherever it falls. Slowly, slowly come back to center to release. Straighten out the legs, bounce it a few times. Coming into wind, releasing on the right side. Rub your hands around the right knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpits. Give it a good squeeze. Massaging organs on the right side as well as ascending colon. Point the left toes up to the ceiling so both legs are engaged. From here, we're going to go spinal twist. Right front on left thigh, opposite hand, opposite thigh. Slowly guide the top knee as close to the floor as possible. Right arm out shoulder height, palms facing down. Turn a little bit of right side of your neck is good. Hips automatically comes off, stretching our lower back muscles. So spinal twist. Good to relieve back pain, as well as massaging internal organs. Make sure your shoulder blade, upper body still on the mat. And we're going to slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs, bounce it a few times. And we're going to repeat on the other side. Wrap your hands around the other knee. Draw it close to the chest or armpit. Give it a good squeeze. Massaging organs on the left side as well as descending colon. Anytime you feel bloated in the abdomen, constipated, you can try this. Lying down or sitting in a chair. Continue to massage organs on this side, and the left side is your descending colon. Now we're going to transition to spinal twist. Left foot on right thigh, opposite hand, opposite thigh. Slowly guide the top knee as close to the floor as possible. Left arm on shoulder height, palms facing down. Turn over the left side of your neck is good. Hips automatically come soft. Stretch, strengthen, and tone the lower back muscles. Creating spaces between L4 and L5, helping you to relieve back pain. And we slowly bring everything back to the center. Straighten out the legs, bounce it a few times. Knee to chest, wrap your arms around your knees, rocking side to side. Coming into a big circular motion if you like, covering a big area. Go the other way. Slowly come back to center. Release the legs down. You're going to drop both knee to the right side. Raise your right arm. Both hands to the right side of your body. Let your blood pressure get adjusted, and when you're ready, use your top arm to push yourself up, coming into a comfortable seated position. So thank you very much for joining me and letting me guide you through the workout. It's always my pleasure.